You just saw one type of dependent samples t-test, where we test out and measure samples from two different populations. In the case of the last example, the populations were the number of errors made typing the 20-word text message within 30 seconds on each keyboard configuration. This is called a repeated measures design, and the null hypothesis is that these two population means will be the same. Before we finish this lesson, I'll tell you about two other types of dependent samples t-tests. One is a longitudinal design, where we measure a variable at one point in time, and then we measure the same variable for the same sample at a later point in time. And we want to know if there's a significant difference between the variable at time 1 and time 2. So the null hypothesis will be exactly the same symbolically as for a repeated measures design. Only with this design, we're putting a lot of time in between measuring the variables. And then a third type of dependent samples design is a pretest post-test, where we measure a variable, implement some kind of treatment, and then measure the same variable for the same sample after the treatment to see if there was a significant effect due to the treatment. Again, the null hypothesis is the same, that the variable won't significantly change before the treatment and after the treatment. You'll see examples of these two types of designs in problem set 10. Great job! T-tests are pretty complicated, so now dive deeper with Dr. Laraway. He's going to go into more detail on these concepts and then go through a full one-sample t-test so you can get a lot of practice and really understand how to use these.